All right, this is Alan from Pittsburgh Music Magazine. I'm here with Doyle. How's it going, man?
Great.
Holy shit, you're big. How much do you work out? Do you have to like work out often when you're on the road? You're gonna laugh at me.
No, because I work out. I'm not
every day. Usually.
Yeah,
do you? It's gonna be difficult on the road, though.
No, wait.
Yeah. Taking with you.
Yeah. Got a bench and blocks.
The blocks on?
Yeah. Yeah. I'm not saying this in a kiss-ass way, but I was extremely impressed with all the work. It's an amazing record. I know that you started playing when you were like 14 or 15, you started playing guitar?
13.
I know that like your brother showed you some stuff and some other people. Are you mainly self-taught? Glenn showed you a lot of stuff?
Glenn showed me, of course. Jerry showed me the notes on the picture.
And then you just kind of went from there. Do you have like a natural talent for music in any sense?
Man, I can't tell you anything about music. All I know is the songs I play.
But you have a prowess for the guitar. I mean, you know your way around the neck. Amazing. Did you fool me? Or,
I mean, I'm fooling you good.
Yeah, but I think you're. I mean, you're really talented. But you have a way of writing.
I finally, yes.
Finally. Do you feel like you're kind of coming into your own?
Yes.
In a way?
Yes. Found the right guy to write with. That's great.
Do you think that that's the key to find someone for you,
well,
at least?
For me, yeah, because once I write the music and I go to write a melody on top, all I see is my hands playing with the fuck I'm listening to, and I just get stuck.
Yeah.
Give it to him. Alex, he doesn't know what I'm playing. He don't fuck what I'm playing.
Yeah. So, you know, you have this amazing persona from, you know, the Misfits. Latched onto it very early on as a kid, you know, a lot of us, and a lot of bands have. Are you really proud of that? You know, when you have a band like Metallica who says, you know, I like it. You know, and they're out there playing your songs, and like one of my favorite moments in the Metallica show, went to see Cleveland last tour, and they're playing, you know, Die, My Dog, and I was just like, oh my god, I'm playing Misfits.
I heard that song the first time driving the car, I listened to it, and I know this song. What is this? And then I heard James sing, I'm like, oh my god, you're doing that too, that's great. It's I think it's cool. You know what the coolest part is about when you meet these people?
It's gotta feel good that you've made an influence.
Well, the funny thing is, they're influenced by the stuff that we did. Now I'm influenced by what they're doing. It's like a circle jerk.
That's neat.
It's crazy.
That's neat. You've done some stuff. You've been playing with Randy a little bit. Playing with God. Did some shows.
No, we didn't do no shows.
Did you play with him at all?
No, I
did. Stage?
He came up and sang a song.
Okay.
Yeah.
Yeah. Did I hear you on Nikki Sixx's show?
No.
I don't think so. I heard you talk, maybe it was with Randy, actually, when you were talking about the time that you clocked the guy with your bass. I did hear that. That was the interview.
Yeah.
Amazing. And I was amazed at that story.
Scary shit. I mean, it's kind of like the same thing that happened to him. I had the same feeling, you know, at that moment.
So it's good. Did you ever think at 16 you'd be here now?
Yeah.
Yeah? Just because your will and your drive and determination?
I'm supposed to be this thing.
Yeah. Very, very intense. That's, you know. never amaze you when you walk around and you see like all these people with these Misfits shirts on that might not even know really, you know, you want to go up to them and go, can you name three Misfits songs? You might not know who you are.
I don't want them to close.
Yeah. Your seat reserved sometimes as well. Tell me a little bit about your gear, your guitar setup. How does that become so personal for a guitar player?
Well, if it doesn't sound the way you want it to sound, you physically try to make it sound like that, then you get this thing called pop my arm, where your fucking arms, like all these finger muscles in here, just get so cramped and tense that you can't fucking do nothing, you can't move it, it flips you out. So you try and get it harder to make that sound come out. Your sound's really good and it feels good and it's like, it's kind of like a liquid sound. You know what I mean? It feels like it's wet, it feels like it's dry and you can't move around on it and you flip out. And it's got this like wet feel to it, so it's gotta be like.
It's all the way down to the strings.
Everything.
Everything. Even your pick.
Oh, yeah.
What kind of, how thick is it?
I have to use 60 millimeters because when I was heavier ones, the strings are so long.
So it's great for now. So you're heavy too. Yeah. Such a, I don't know, you don't, a lot of guys rely on, you know, all those effects and everything. You're just,
that's what pedals is
like? Yeah. But you know, you're more,
yeah. I love the same. Even on solos and stuff, I got some pedals in my doors.
I mean, everybody has pedals, but you don't have 90 and some guy in the back, you know, tweaking everything.
That would be nice. You know, 11 of them sitting in the cabinet.
Do you sometimes get bummed out where the music business has gone these days? Because you've been in this for a long time and you come from that punk ethic. It's such a hard business.
It's not the music you hang out and have a good time. It's the business.
Yeah, right.
It's hard to understand what to do, what's right to do. That's why we can't label ourselves. This record and all my records are going to come out on our own label. Now, what you get a fucking record deal and it takes you 10 years to recoup the money. Okay? They pay for the record, they put it all out. It takes 10 years for you to make a fucking penny. When you do make a penny, make 70 cents for the whole fucking band. What the fuck am I gonna do with that?
Yeah.
No, I'm the label. I make $7 a record now. And I'm only gonna sell this many fucking records. Let's keep all the money. You know, that way we can keep making more music. You know, if it's also with the downloading, stealing it. If you steal music, it's like coming into a fucking motorcycle factory stealing a fucking motorcycle. What is that, Brian? It's a fucking crime,
yeah, right?
You know, you steal our songs, now we gotta go get jobs. Because we have no fucking money, and you want more songs. What the fuck are we gonna make if we're working 8 hours a day? I don't wanna write a song after I work 8 hours a day. I'll blow my fucking brains out. Right?
Absolutely.
So if you want more music, don't fucking steal it. Just fucking give us a dollar a song. What the fuck? Yeah, I don't have a song tree in my yard. If I did, fucking steal it, bro.
Absolutely.
I don't. It's hard to write a song. It's 12 fucking notes. You're making a puzzle that has no fucking, you know, there's no direction. With 12 fucking pieces. You know, it's fucking hard.
I'm amazed at what musicians have done already and what you continue to do. And it's, it's not sappy, but I thank you for what you do because you brought pleasure to my life. And, you know, you get through times and you get pumped up at times and it's awesome, you know. And, I'm happy to give over $1 or $2, $20, come to a show and pay for things because that keeps you doing what you're doing and you keep giving back to me. It's an easy cycle to be part of.
The kids today, you know, they're so instantly gratified with a computer right now. It's like a microwave world.
Yeah.
But you know, you gotta pay for that shit, man. You want more.
Yeah.
You can't make more for work.
Well, we appreciate it. Keep doing it, man. I know you've got another record that's in the can, and I know that this is just coming out physically, Abominator. So I'm kind of excited it's here at the show, because I have the digital copy. I'm going to go grab the physical copy. I know, but I'm just excited. I still want to have it in my hands and check out all the artwork,
get all the words and shit.
Yeah, I'm excited to grab that. But just excited to see you, you know, out doing things with Glenn. It's a real true honor to be in Arkansas. So beautiful. Thanks so much.
That's it. You guys got more time, man.
Keep going.
Really?
Yeah,
you don't
worry.
I mean,
I don't want to keep you. I ain't on until fucking 10 o'clock, man.
Yeah.
I'm going to wear this class suit until then. Let's go.
That's gotta be rough.
It sucks. It makes me tired. I like when I just finish and I go on.
Yeah. So, when do you think you might be able to go on?
We're working on that right now. We're working on that. We want to get the right tour. We don't want to go out and headline because it's not going to be the things we want. We almost got the Rob Zombie one tour. That was close. It was close, man. So we want to go with bigger bands like that, you know?
Yeah.
That would have been awesome.
Yeah, we want to do that for a while until we see a lot of people coming for us. You know?
Yeah.
That way we can jump to headlining. You know, we're going to be right. You know, we'll have that other record done, so if we start rolling, we don't have to stop. Booking tours, just drop them while we're going.
So now that you are kind of in control, because you really, you know, kind of put everything, your heart and soul into this record, but you're also, you're the record company. You know, you're the bank, in essence. Is Alex a part of that at all, or is he just like your brand partner? Like, I'm not necessarily financially, but like mentally.
Oh, yeah. Without him, there's no me. I can't fucking
attention. Do you bounce like business ideas off of each other too?
You know why I let the managers fucking do that now?
Yeah.
Fuck, you know?
Yeah, come on. You've been in a business for so long. You've learned a lot.
It's a very complicated business.
Absolutely.
Make a mistake is fuck.
Yeah. It's hard to trust people too. How do you find that right manager, right person?
You gotta find the guy who wants to do it, and that's the only thing he's doing, and that's what he wants to do, and that's the guy that wants to do it.
Yeah.
Everybody who's working with me right now wants to do this project, that's what they want.
You seem to have kept a good relationship with Glenn over the years. Why isn't the other guys? I mean, I don't want to get personal.
I don't know. Honestly, they just, they clash, you know? They
don't want to be lost.
Yeah, I'm ready to do this between them right now. Right now, put my shit on the side.
And everybody wants it.
Me too.
The desire is
there. It's not me. It's those two guys got to fucking just say, okay, this is how it's going to be. Let's go.
Because we as fans, I mean, we're excited to see the set tonight. What? Well, we obviously want a full set.
Imagine a new record.
Oh,
yeah. A full fucking set.
That would be amazing. That would be actually.
Right?
Absolutely.
Get you to come out.
Absolutely.
We might make you work double time, but that would be.
I can do it.
You can do it, man.
I know.
Ain't thinking of the exposure.
I'm a fucking beast, you know? Man. I can do that shit.
I mean, it would be amazing. People would come in droves. That would blow everybody's mind. It's unfortunate. All those things kind of get in the way.
Well, you never know, man. I don't know. I think it's a great one.
We can keep hoping. Maybe it'll happen at the right time. The right place. Maybe it's just one of those big festival shows. Maybe just start it off. You know, get the right feel happening. Definitely. Do you ever interact with fans much? Do you find that uncomfortable?
You know, sometimes when they drop, there's an asshole they always find you.
Do you feel funny signing stuff?
Funny.
Like, do you feel like, man, this is like stupid? I'm sure they're all, and just going nuts. Yeah, do you get like a natural high from that?
When I'm signed or playing?
No, when you're playing.
I'm sorry. Playing? I don't really know.
You're just into your zone. Yeah. It's not easy playing those guitar parts. You know, concentrate. I mean, does any of that kind of, adrenaline hit you?
Or you get better?
Hard to come off stage sometimes from that. Come down. No, that doesn't.
Come down.
Who were some of the people that have influenced you along the way, all these years that have helped you? Just maybe not even playing, but just like music-wise, as far as like surviving in the business. Have you met some people along the way that really affected you in some way?
You mean like bands?
Yeah, bands or just people in general, people in bands that you've met and worked with, obviously you've played with tons of different people.
I guess it takes something from everybody.
Yeah.
You get everybody's attitude on the whole situation. You know what I mean? A lot of people can't do this. It's not easy. It's a fucking job. It's a hard job. Gotta be an athlete to do it. Fucking get all fucked up every night. I don't know how to fucking do it.
Yeah. You were never into that scene at all?
I mean, I'll get drunk with Johnny Kelly once in a while, but it's peer pressure. It's like, have a drink. Shot.
Yeah. That was never part of your scene throughout.
Oh, no.
So it was never any problem throughout the band's history.
No.
That's amazing. When you think about all the bands that you see all the time, just whether it's boredom or whatever. It's about bands getting into that.
Yeah. Well, it's like teach you what the monkey was when they're out here, you know what I mean?
Yeah. What else are you thinking? Obviously, you like to keep yourself fit. Obviously, you watch what you eat and so forth. But what other interests do you have besides music?
There is no time for any other interests.
Really? It's just a whole. You're pretty focused.
Yeah, you should do that.
You know, like you're not into like reading or movies or anything reading, like that.
I like good movies. I like football, but I can't watch it now anymore.
Well, because you're broke.
My team's horrible right now.
Who's your team?
Giants are. They're playing tonight, actually.
We've had a bad year in Pittsburgh, so we won yesterday. It's been an unusual year here.
Yeah, steal us too, man. You know what? It clears my Sunday up. I don't have to worry about watching the game. I'm done.
Well, there you go.
I'm like, all right.
You're not missing anything, right?
Doesn't matter.
Do you guys change up the what you play each night?
Sometimes a little slightly, we can't suggest that too much.
Usually the wire. Runway or the highway. I mean, he seems kind of set in his ways.
Well, he wants to sing. I guess he wants to sing into the songs he knows, or.
Yeah.
Well, no, I know. I don't want to ask Steve, see, how's it go? He shows me, I got it. In 2 seconds.
Right. It's a lot of songs to hear really, and hear.
Yeah, why don't you do it?
Muscle memory? It's only chords. Maybe I should have brought a guitar and had you teach me.
Nah.
Like, no, that's a lot more. Your ass gonna look a lot more. So when do you think we'll see the next tour?
This one hasn't come out yet.
I mean, yeah, officially.
So
Are you
maybe
thinking about
9 months or a year?
I mean, that's not bad. I mean, that's kind of what I was getting to. I mean, that's pretty close.
Yeah.
I mean, can't believe you guys did those 18 songs, but I think that's really smart business wise. Give all that stuff away.
Me and Alex just started fucking writing like crazy. We were doing sometimes 4 songs a month. And they were all great. Every time one of them would come back, and I would sit there with the headphones and put it in and just be like, oh my god, fucking lyrics, it's really cool and stuff.
Where do you find that those lyrics come from?
He's crazy. Fuck guys, that's my mind. He believes every fucking word he's saying too. I can't believe it. That guy's fucking
amazing.
It's the real deal.
It certainly helps you. What about you with writing? Where does that? You just kind of sit down with the guitar, man. And it just comes out?
It's music. I'll either piece songs together or sometimes they'll just come out in one shot.
That's amazing to me. That you're able to do that.
It amazes me that it happens. I'm so holy shit.
That's, I think people don't really understand how hard it is doing this on the tour.
But you can get past the part of deciding when your writing's good. That's the thing too. The right song. Be like, I don't know if it's good.
Yeah. But it's kind of like you're putting your balls out there for everybody to see in a way.
I like writing the music first because you kind of try and make it different parts of the parts of playing when you hear it. You know, then he puts the vocals on it, so he's great at the melody, he's great. I like the whole thing too.
How much do you have to do with the studio? Are you comfortable in the studio?
I like doing it the way we're doing it. We do it by ourselves.
Yeah.
Going when I want to do it, everything's set up. If I want to leave, if I can't play that song that day, I go home. Like, fuck this, I can't do this today.
Yeah. Do you feel like really comfortable? Like, you know, I mean, obviously you've been in the studio plenty of times.
I don't like being in the studio where somebody's recording me and everybody's sitting there.
Yeah.
That's a lot of pressure for me.
So just like it, it's just you.
Me by myself. He's by himself.
Okay.
Chuck comes in by himself.
You leave your parts for each other.
Yeah. I go first.
Okay.
Turn the guitar and bass and hand it to them. Turn it off. No.
Oh, fuck it, ain't going there. I'm with y'all.
Wouldn't be the first time, brother.
Count Tecula. That's where all the Red Bull goes every night.
My first one.
Okay.
But I plan on slamming another one right after this.
Yesterday.
But this is not the sugar-free shit, so I don't drink that crap. I want all the sugar and twice the caffeine.
They need to take the bubbles out of that fucking shit.
They do the hippie speedball. Smoke weed and drink Red Bull.
It's a hippie speedball.
Well, it's technically supposed to be coffee. Coffee and weed.
I'm drinking about 4 of those before I go on there. I'm just burping myself. The
4? Dude, yeah. Because your heart just doesn't say, hey, you're all right.
We're done.
I could probably drink a gallon of that.
Oof. Man, 2 of them and I'm just fucking singing.
Oh.
Plus it gives me heartburn, too.
That's bad. It's rude. Okay, it's our Red Bull club.
Yeah.
Redbull.com.
Yeah. All right.
What up? Take the fucking bubbles out, man. Make it like Gatorade.
Just shake the fuck out of it for a while. It'll go flat. It's like soda.
Who's got time for
gas?
You need a paint fucking mix of that. Put the whole 6 in there. Like all day. Make this float, man.
You ever thought about writing for other people?
It's hard enough to write for myself.
Okay.
You know, there's a few people I want to write with, but I had to get this other record done so I can fucking think. I got to finish something, you know, to move on to something else. I go crazy.
Do you like being at home? Do you like being out there?
I like this part.
Yeah. You think too much home?
Think
true. Yeah.
I don't think at all, man. It hurts my head. I don't want to think. Fuck.
But, you know, so if you, the touring is where you feel most at home,
you do,
most where you want to be.
Once you get back on the bus, you're like, ah, I'm home. It's fucked up, right? Getting that bump in the car. That's the best part of it.
Yeah.
That's pretty rough.
I try to learn as much about the business as you can. Because there are people that I think we've all seen the VH1 behind the music specials and read enough. I mean, I read a lot of the music bios and stuff and just see how many people get screwed up in the business. It's just sad. You know, some amazing talents out there who are broke.
Well, you know what it is too? They think there's always going to be more money. Just like one of
them. Yeah. One of the most impressive.
It's hard to do.
Oh, no. It's easy.
It's easy, yeah.
Yeah, and these people have entourages, you know, and then they let the, you know, they see these things on MTV and let the record company get them a house, cars. They don't own any of that shit. That's what no one understands. They don't own any of that stuff. The record company owns all that crap. It all goes away. You know, well, it seems like you've been pretty smart. To a degree. I mean, I'm not that.
I would like to be smart. How do I get smart?
You're very self-deprecating. You humble? Is that one of the tools you use throughout the years to kind of,
I don't even know what that means.
You put yourself down a little bit in order to, I think, to keep yourself, just, you know, have, keep yourself, you know, it's not like, hey, I was in the Misfits. You know? That's cool. You know, I think, you know, you know, people get upset. You know, I think that Glenn gets a bad rap sometimes for some of the stuff that's in the press.
There's only so much shit you can take. You know, people break these fucking balls. You can take this much, you know, like, you know what, fuck you.
Yeah. And I don't know the guy. And I don't know the inner workings of what goes on with him day to day. So I can't judge him. You know, well, I just have to see what's in the media. But I can't judge him by that because we all know half of that's bullshit. Right? It's only part of the story. You know, I don't know what goes on.